Very important and relevant Bible quote to our time. And we are now in a day which is a year, not going to the Jewish one, to the terrible massacre which happened on the 7th of October. Wild beasts of the Hamas, new Nazis, killed young and old in terrible ways, kidnapping people. You know the whole story, frightening. More than 1,000 of Israelis were killed in a very cruel way. No doubt something which is difficult to explain logically. How people can be so cruel, so bad. This is really what they are. Amalekite. And this is the character of the Amalekites, being very, very cruel. Like Germany, the Nazis, Amalek. So this is also Amalek. So today they're commemorating this day, you know, by what? Telling story, terrible story about what happened, the people who were killed, murdered, and so on. No. I think there's another way, Jewish way, that you have commemorate such things. You have to think to yourself, maybe I have to improve my ways. Maybe this happened because I did not behave properly. Yeah. This was the Rebbe said, I don't say this. So as I said, we see here, it is in Hebrew, but I've got to explain to you properly, I hope, every detail that appears in this table. The first thing many people always want to know, where the place is, what is the location of the Torah. So you can see here, Aleph, it means Aleph is the first book, Genesis, and it starts from chapter 21, probably is the verse by the way, and goes down to chapter 48, verse 7. Okay. This is the distance, the skip from this location, the Torah. Definitely, the whole story in the Torah, I didn't go into it, because this is something definitely that you have to learn. Only I look for best meetings, definitely, to our situation. Because this is the Torah, and this is really what Rabbi said to do, if it is definitely has the right scientific condition, as you see just now. And also, it was recognized by science. It's a mitzvah, a great mitzvah, to show it. This is what Rabbi Shmuel Weirbach and Rabbi Shlomo Fischer said, and Rabbi Albersham. But it's a proof that Torah from heaven, because this is written already, Rabbi Nubach, under 800 years ago, use this code for the birth of the moon every 42 letters and so on, because it's the internet. So what we have here, and what is the lesson that we should learn for such a thing when to commemorate? So the first thing, I took the Hebrew dates of the 7 October at the time. So it was Kaf Bet 22, on the month of Tishrei. And this is a day of Simchas Torah, the day of Torah, and was Shabbos at that time, very holy and important days, right, in Judaism. What more we have here? The date where it happened was Hey 5000, Tavshin 784. This was exactly the year, then the beginning the year. So you have here best meeting, by the way. This is what I was looking for the day 22 of Tishrei on the year 8 of Shin Pedalet 5700. This is what came here. So definitely automatically I look for other important verse connected with the story. So let us start from up. So right on top here, we have something very interesting, which I could not find usually in other tables, because a lot of letters not so common. ג'יהאד. ג'יהאד. לא מתי ג'יהאד. ג'יהאד is for the Arab, holy war. Yeah? Holy war. Fighting, you know that. Killing, murdering, young and old. Holy war. No, this was a believe in. You can see, it was in the internet. They said, why is he killed? Why is he murdered? Jews said they deserve death. Why? Because the robbers, they took their country, Israel. Israel belonged to them and Jews took it. So they deserve death. Young and old Jews all together should have this massacre because of this. So what more we have here? You know that unfortunately we have to believe. This is the basis of Judaism, to believe that all troubles that we have has a reason. No, a reason. The Torah said 98 curses in the portion of Kitavo. You have all the curses, the Holocaust, what happened, the massacre now. Everything is there, 98 curses. But in Tugashni, I'm not Tishmo, if you will not listen to my laws. 98 curses. Everybody's point out, in 98, the numerical word is the Hebrew word chetz, errors. Errors in the Torah really refers to the enemies of Israel, chetzai, errors. And Shem Shmuel, one of the commentators of this is that if you take this letter, chetz, back where is tzach, tzach is to clean, to purify. Right? Because it's the purpose of troubles. To purify our heart, to do tshuva, to repent. Now, when Jews are sinning, unfortunately, this is written, yeah? Then they give force to two evil forces. One is called Lili, yeah? It's here, letter after letter, Lili. And to Samael, yeah? See, Samael. Lili is a power of lust to do with Arabs. You know, Arabs a lot of wives. But them lust, and you could see their behavior with this Israeli girls, women. So this is written clearly indicating to us that the evil forces of the Arabs that we saw, unfortunately, got their power from the heavenly angel, this, by the way, on this one we pray three times a day, remove from us this one. Then you have Gaza, the place, the root of evil from where it comes. I brought it in a Kabbalistic book, that if you take the inner letter of the Aza, like Ayin Yud Nun, and Zayin Yud Nun, and A Aleph, the Gematria 131, which is the Gematria of the evil force, Samael, yeah, and Eichmann, yeah, unfortunately. So, those are these people. You have Patach, PLO, because they also participated definitely in this massacre. So, what more we have? The first thing, by the way, we have here, the Hebrew word massacre. Tevach, the massacre, yeah. Later after here, the massacre, this is what happened. Then, what more we have here? You have definitely the Amalekite in green. Amalek, yeah, the Amalekite. And here we have Arabim, Arabs, because all the Arabs basically agreed with what the Hamas did. No one, no Arab, yeah, protested and said, oh, how could they do such a thing? No, it looks that all of them agreed to this massacre. And relying as the understanding that Israelis are robbers and deserve death. So very small skip on Avim, when he's backward, it means that it's judgment. So you have Amalekim, Amalek, the Amalekites, you have the Arabs here. Frightening, you have PLO at home. And then you have who is pushing all these things. In fact, it is known that this massacre was already planned by Iran. Yeah. So you have here the word Iran in red, Iran. And whom they used to make this massacre, to kill and to murder and to kidnap? Hamas. Here, Hamas in red. חמאס in red and Iran in red. Yeah, lot of blood. So amazing that Hamas can be Iran because they were acting, what's this? So what more behavior? What more behavior? Uh-huh. Here is the name of the Samael, the heavenly minister of the Amalek, Amalekash. Kabbalah says that Samael means blinding God, because our forces who don't want God to interfere in this world, frightening. I mean, atheists, yeah, non-believers, the leftists, we have to, yeah, unbelievable. In this one also we pray three times a day, Shemini Yagol Melacha, remove from us the sun and the lilies, because they are the main sources, the troublemakers of everything, Arabs and Edom, Europe. Then, what more behavior? Should have something good, because all the purpose of the troubles is to bring Jews to do Teshuva, to have Messiah. So amazingly, we have here, sons of Joseph, because it's written, the sons of Joseph, the Messiah, son of Joseph, he will be this one, we will wipe away, remove from this world these evil forces of Hamas, anti-Semite, and all this. This is the power. Then comes son of Jesse, and they bring light, Torah to the world, but removing all the troubles, the troublemaker, all the enemies of Israel, all the anti-Semites will be son of Joseph. I will do it. We see already he did a good job that most of those people, maybe not the most, who did this murder, they are not anymore in this world. They are in hell very likely. Yeah? It's unbelievable, you know, almost everyone who took part in this is not here. So, no, sons of Joseph will come. We will do Teshuva, we will keep the Torah, because all this is what we see here. And only then we have Messiah, you see Mashiach. Messiah will come, and now we have, unfortunately, the labor pain of Messiah. Yeah, which is unfortunately because the birth, like before, the birth of a lady. Lots of pains, yeah. So, this is, by the way, very interesting ideas that say the 100th time, you know, you have to blow in shofar, 100th time, yeah? So there are different reasons. And one of them is because a woman pregnant, which is now ready to give birth, and she has the pains, you know, this is a normal thing that you have pain, labor pain. So if together you take the small, bigger, come 200, this is what they said. So they said, the Meshech Chochma said, so the same thing is Jews are blowing 100 kiyot, yeah? 100 blowings, as this is like a woman who gets the baby after 100 cryings, yeah? The same thing, this is the Messiah will come, unfortunately, after those terrible suffering, yeah, that we have now, hoping that soon it will come. So I think that it is so unfortunate that the whole day today to commemorate, to remember the day, the 7th of October. Okay, stories and so on. Remember, now you know how cruel these people are, they are Nazis, you know how they did. But what it changed us, it did something to us, nothing. The purpose of commemorating things like this is simple to change, to strengthen our faith in God, because we have to understand why it happened. No, I don't say, but Rebbe said, the days are creating the Sabbath and Simchas Torah. Ah, so what it is, you know, the Torah tells us. The Torah tells us the Jews came out of Egypt, and the Amalekites came to fight with them. Why? So before it's written, because they desecrate the Shabbos. Yeah, this is what our Rebbe said in the Tartek Shabbos, that because of desecrating the Shabbos, Amalekites came. Exactly. This is Amalek of today. Comes because they desecrate the Shabbos. Simchas Torah, the holiest then sanctified days. This then the Talmud says another reason, because Amalek came to attack Pewtum. So it came to attack. Why? Because Jews ask question. They ask question. Is God with us? Is God not with us? And so on. That faith in God. By Abu Amalek, Amalek came to attack them, to fight with them. A third time also, the Talmud that talked at Shabbos brings, they were loose in fulfilling commandments, mitzvahs. Okay, they did it, but yeah, with no intention, with no really. And this is very bad. So, Rephidim in Hebrew, this is the place where the war of Amalek took place, Rephidim. And Rephidim means loose hands. By the way, the Rephidim still exists. In the name of Rephidim, a place. This was a place, the first place that the Israelites gave to the Egyptian in Sinai. They gave all Sinai. This was the first place with a nice celebration. No, Rephidim, it looked like this, when we are still losing Kippur, Mitzvot, and Shabbos. This is what I said. This is what is written, and this is what Rabbi said. It was said. So I only try to show you. One should know that the purpose of the Bible code, yeah, which now Baruch Hashem will recognize scientifically, it's really true. Yeah, if you had the best meetings, you know, minimal and so on. But this is the most important to strengthen our faith. This is why it came now. Because faith, our Rabbi tells us that in merit of faith, Jews came out of Egypt. In the merit of faith, we will come from the exile that we are now by the Arabs, Ishmael, and Edom, in Europe. Right? This is all written. So this is the purpose of this. I mean, really, what the code shows is what the Torah says. The Torah tells us, if you don't keep this, you will have jihad. If you are doing sins, this will come, and so on. Lilith will be strong in Peolo, and Gaza, the source of this will start. You know, all this comes here. Yeah, all this comes here, as you can see. Yeah. Everything, Amalek, and everything. Everything the Torah says, the Medrash says. Only, unfortunately, it doesn't make such impression that some people are much more impressed when they see a table, especially scientists, who see that it is very highly statistic. As Professor Michelson said himself, that he became religious because of this. Dr. Rottenberg, they said clearly, yeah. But this is honest people, people who don't have pride, only they believe, if this is the truth, I have to do. So this is truth, Amalek is here. Yeah, the Arabs will unfortunately behave like this. Sons of Joseph is really minimal.